Today we will discuss how to create the pluggable database in Oracle 19c. For creation of the pluggable database in Oracle 19c, we will use DBCA. Moreover, we will add the sample schema in pluggable database. So very first steps to for the creation of the database in Oracle 19c, we have to launch the database configuration assistant. So very first step is start DBCA. Where we can start it, just search it over here, DBCA, or simply we can write it over here, database configuration assistant. Click it, it will take some time to start. So database configuration assistant will help to perform the different type of operation with the database. We can install, we can create, we can configure the database. So here we have to create the pluggable database. So very first step, click on manage pluggable database. So when we click on manage pluggable database, click next. So very next step is start DBCA. Next is manage pluggable database. In next steps, we have to select create a pluggable database. Create pluggable database. When we select create pluggable database, click on next. Now here our container, select container database, that is already selected ORCL. So we select this one as it is, and we are already authenticated by the window. Click on next. So container database selection, that is already selected, and the name of container database is ORCL. Now we have to create a new pluggable database from the PDBs. We have to select the pluggable database. So this default option PDB seed is okay, although we have the other pluggable database are there, we can select them, but now we are selecting exists the pluggable database, and it is PDB seed. Click next. Now we have to create the pluggable database name. So I am using it over here, the database name, database one, our class names, database one, our pluggable database name is database one, and I am using the pass user name, same names that we have, database one, pluggable database. We can use any passwords, so I am using the complex password. When I use it over here, complex password, click on next button. And now here, storage type, we are having the file system, that's fine. And database location, by default location is app, db, bilal, then ORA data, ORCL, and pluggable database name is database one. So over there in ORA database, ORA data, we are having ORCL, and then pluggable database will be there. Click next. Now it will ask to create the database, pluggable database. Now click on finish. It will take some time for the creation of the pluggable database. It is very first step that we have to start database configuration assistant and select the option of manage pluggable database. Configuration is in process. It will take very short time to create the pluggable database. When pluggable database is created, next step is we have to connect with the SQL plus, and then we have to check that this one database is created or not. Now it's a pluggable database, database 1 successfully created. Click on close button. Now we have to open the SQL plus. In SQL plus we have to connect with the sys user, sys as sysdba. Now show pdbs, it will display the different pluggable databases. Our new pluggable database, that is O database 1, and its open mode is read and write. If we want to check the different type of the services, so services of the pluggable database, database 1 will be there. Now we have to alter session, set container is equal to ORCL, sorry, set container is equal to database 1. Now session is altered. If we checked over here, different services of this one, so we will have the services select name from the dollar symbol services. So it will display the services over here, database 1. Now next step is we have to make the changes in the TNS name.ora file. So open the in app, we are having the DB home, then network, and then admin. Here we are having TNS name.ora file, notepad. Click it over here, click on OK. So our pluggable database name is database 1. So copy all of lost this one, copy it, and we will have a database 1, and service name is here again database 1. Our database name is pluggable database name is database 1, and service name is also database 1. Save it. Now we edit over at TNS name.ora files. Process is done. Make changes and TNS name dot ora file, right, and add the services over there then TNS name dot ora files. Now we have to check the different databases, different users. So how to check the user? Select username from all underscore users, select username from all underscore users. So we will have the 36 different users are here. Our sample schema like HR is not available. How we can install the HR schema? So we already discussed in one video that how to add the sample schema over here. So we can edit using one example. Let me see how we can. Our sample schema HR will be available in app DB home. Here we are having the demo. Then we have schema and schema. Human resource, a file, main file is here, HR underscore main. So copy this one file, path, HR underscore main dot SQL is the main path, @ to install the sample schema in the newly created pluggable database, database 1. So slash HR underscore main is the name of file, HR underscore main.sql is the name of file. Click on enter. Specify password for the HR user. So we say the password for HR user is HR. Enter. Now default user space. So we are having the users table space. For this one user is users. So specify the temporary table space. We say that is a temp. Now, path for the log file. So we have to provide the path for the log file in the same demo folder. We are having the schema and then log. We can assign any path over here. So we can assign copy it slash. We can use it over here. So it will start creating the different type of the table, alter table, sessions, and a different operation will be performed over here. Okay, now procedure is completed successfully. If we check it over here, again select username from all underscore users. It said that now HR user is here. We have to alter this one user. Alter user HR identified by HR. Account unlock. If account is locked, now we may be able to connect HR slash HR at the rate of our pluggable database name is. What is the pluggable database or what are the different services are there? Select name from V dollar symbol services. So here services name is database one. So we may be able to connect HR slash HR at the rate of ORC, sorry, VRF services database one. Now we are connected with the HR user. If you want to check the different type of the table, all the table will be there, like select count steric from employees. So 107 records are there in the employee table. Select steric from tab. All the table will be here. 8 different tables are here in the new sample schema. So in this way, we may be able to create the new pluggable database in Oracle 19c, and also we may be able to add this sample schema in newly created database. Thanks for watching the video.